My name is Carmen Nacora Lopez. I am the fourth sibling. There are five siblings in the family. The first sibling, the eldest, is her name is Euphemia. Her nickname is Femi. Okay. Or they call her Inyang, you see. And then the second sibling, her name is Philomena, and her nickname is Lomen or Luming or Philomena or something like that. And then my third sibling, her name is Rosalia, and they call her Rosal. Her nickname is Rosal or Rose or Rosie or something like that. My nickname, they call me Maming. Maming or Carmen. The youngest sibling, the number five sibling, his name, he is the only boy in the family. His name is Jose and his nickname is Joe. Since I arrived in 1952, and he arrived in 1951 already, you see. He was a student at USF, and I was a student at San Francisco State College. There were many admirers, and they would come and visit me and offer to marry them. And here comes this other young student, and he was good looking. he was tall, he was handsome, and dark. Okay. He was tall, handsome, and dark. But then I could not make my decision because there were so many. Whenever one of my suitors came to visit me, and then he would call when he gets home, and that made my sister Euphemia get mad at me. She would say, "Whoa, He just came to visit you, and he's calling again." You know. But anyway, I accepted him with a humble heart. But God was in control.
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset. Swiftly flow the day.
In 1955, we got married. We got married in a Methodist church. And even the other pastor who married us was one of my suitors too. He was an applicant. Our first two children, the eldest is a girl and her name is Grace. The second child is a boy, you see. His name is Glenn, you see. The third and the fourth, their names are Carl and Nene. Grace and Glenn were born, natural born here in San Francisco. And the third and fourth sibling, that's Carl and Nene now, they were born in Baguio City, Philippines. I was a very innocent, homely person, just like Cinderella type. That's my type.
So fill me up, buttercup, don't break my heart. I'll be over at 10, it's only time and again, but you're late.
I am sharing this beautiful personal experience now, I cannot stop but share it to others so that they will experience too the love of God through Jesus Christ, you see. During the outbreak of the Second World War, as far as I can remember, I was then a high school student and I was in my senior year. We lived under fear. I also got sick. Everybody thought I was going to die. The worst part that I can describe about the seriousness of my sickness is that my weight, I lost so much weight. I lost my appetite to eat. And furthermore, everything that would give me strength to make me well, which came from food totally, I rejected them. But it's because my sister, my grandmother, those loving members of the family, they wanted me to live, so I was forced to eat. In fact, my elder sister, Philomena, would say, if you want to live, just eat, just swallow it. As a young person growing to be a teenager, you see, I thought I would not be able to continue my studies and also continue to live a life. Because of my faith, God brought me here. God let me live. God let me survive. God let me become what I am today. And that is sharing that faith in God through the name Jesus, the Lord Jesus. I call Him my Lord and my Savior when I accepted Him.
That say